Check out ProBoxingSupplies.com, PowerPerformanceProducts.com, and you're watching MMAInterviews.tv.
Meet one of the faces of the UFC's new flyweight division.
Hey, this is Ian McCall, Uncle Creepy. I fight for the UFC against Demetrius Johnson on March 3rd. It doesn't get any cooler than this. I get to be the first flyweight UFC champion of the world. It just feels good to be recognized and be part of the first four people that are in this thing.
I'm sure you're wondering, how did McCall possibly get one of the best nicknames in all of MMA?
My friend lives in Vegas. He's a bartender, and his kid's barely free back then. So I'm the sober driver. We get home, 3 a.m, and I'm trying to tire out the baby. And he comes up with a skateboard. Uncle Ian, Uncle Creepy, skateboard. I was like, oh, wow. Just called me Uncle Creepy. And of course, everyone who was in their drunken stupor woke up and heard that, and they were like, that's your nickname.
McCall is ready to unleash Uncle Creepy on Mighty Mouse.
He's obviously fast. He's good at what he does. But he really only seems to do one thing, and he always has the same game plan, which is it wins. You know, he wins. He wins doing it. Sure, he's faster than everybody at 35s, but welcome to 125. He's a beeline fighter. He just goes straight. You know, he walks forward with all of his punches. His takedowns are all in a straight line. So angles is going to be a big part of my game. I think I hit a lot harder. I don't think he's any better at wrestling than I am, or jiu-jitsu. So he's a good opponent. He's, you know, ranked in the world for a reason, but I don't see it being something I can't overcome.
Overcoming obstacles is something McCall has quite a bit of experience with.
I've done a lot of stupid things in my life. I've been to jail a couple times, been in rehab twice. I've had a constant struggle with drugs and alcohol. I signed to fight in the hospital. You gotta grow up sometime. I can't sell drugs anymore. I can't get in street fights. I'm sick of going to jail. I'm sick of, you know, having to pay for the bad things I do.
McCall's realization came at a perfect time as he was given an opportunity to reinvent himself at Tachi Palace fights against the world's top-ranked flyweight, Juicier De Silva. Ian lost the first round to De Silva, but persevered to a unanimous decision victory. He then took a fight against undefeated prospect Dustin Ortiz. The young Ortiz was no match for McCall, and he dominated in every way from bell to bell. The win earned Uncle Creepy a shot at the Tachi Palace flyweight belt against the champ Daryl Montague. After a close first round, McCall began to take control, starting with this right hand that dropped the mongoose. His wrestling and ground and pound wore the champ down, and he sunk in a rear naked choke to earn the belt, solidifying his number one ranking and spot in the UFC's four-man flyweight tournament.
It's been a long time coming! Woo!
Ian's got a heck of a support system with an awesome family that's always there to support him, including one epic grandmother.
I just say Jude, the Sacred Heart of Jesus, 3 rosaries, everything, and he won. Thank you. I'm hyperactive. They used to call me Cyclone in high school. Ian, I love you and I'm so proud of you.
Ian now has a wife and daughter of his own to love and support, making it even easier to keep his eye on the prize.
I don't have any chance to slack off, to screw around. I've got a wonderful wife who does everything I need. I have a beautiful daughter now who's a little over 3 months. It keeps me focused. Now I have two people to provide for instead of just myself.
The next step for becoming the first UFC flyweight champion and superstardom is Sydney, Australia, where he takes on his toughest test to date in Demetrius Johnson.
I'm very confident I can stay off my back. Like I said, it's angles. How do you beat someone going in a straight line, just cut angles? And it's not like he's any better at wrestling than me. I've watched tape. My coaches have all watched tape. My wrestling coaches have all watched tape. You know, my wrestling doesn't suck. Someone's going to be able to put hands on Demetrius. I've dropped everybody else I fight, and I'm only getting strong, and I'm only punching harder. So I think I'll be able to put him out within 3 rounds. Make sure to watch UFC on FX. It's the opening of the flyweights. We're going to be the most exciting fighters in the UFC by far, and We'll make you guys proud and make you happy to watch.
Godspeed and party on.